Mikiani. Today's video, we're going to take a walk back through the year of 2016 at my top 5 wigs that brought me so much joy. Now, let me tell you, there were so many different wig changes in my life last year because I really decided that I was going to take my hair growth very, very seriously, really look at wigs as a different styling option for protective styles. But it really morphed into something else. Like, my wigs became a part of my identity. People were always asking me what unit I had on, and it was, of course, just like anything else that's new. Once it's new, it becomes old, and then you're looking for that new again. And of course, through that journey, there were some duds. There were some things that I really liked because they were new. And then I had the opposite end of the coin. The things that I loved about some wigs made me buy them more than one time. So we're going to walk through some of my different color changes that I really like and the reasons why. And of course, we're going to get into those top fives right now. So as I went through my chronicles of units, I decided the best way to go through my top 5 were to start with colors. And you guys know that I love to play with colors, and that led me to these beautiful units right here. This one being the Madu. I'll leave the link for this unit in the description box. Of course, it's a beautiful burgundy shade. It's a very, very loose, like natural looking unit. Absolutely was obsessed over this unit. This is what I call one of my everyday units, and it just served me so well, especially during the summertime. Very, very lightweight. The color was dead on. Like, that burgundy was popping when I had a tan. And of course, I loved her so much that I had her in a beautiful natural brown. Both of these colors allowed me to transition to blonde back to darker rooting, and I was completely obsessed with them. So I will leave in the description box these units, and if they're still available, just click that link and you'll be able to find your way right to it. And I have to say, with these two units, this one I think really was bought first. This unit, the brown one, was bought first, and of course I went back in to get another one of these and I saw the burgundy and I just fell in love with it. So I'm going to say there's a toss-up, but because I love the burgundy more than I love the brown, I'm going to say the brown is number 5. The burgundy is number 4. Let's move into spot number 3. So the colors that I really played with, I'm going to say more so toward the end of the year, were the darker units. Like, I was bound and determined to get over my fear of dark units. My hair is really naturally brown, and going through the whole transition of loving my hair and protective hairstyling, like, I really didn't want it to be so crazily obvious. For people that really don't know what I'm doing, sometimes they'll see me with the wig, sometimes they'll see me with my natural hair braided down, and I just didn't want that color shock change. So those moments that I was a little bit more hesitant, I wanted to play with the darker in color. So that led me to this beautiful unit right here, and please, please excuse her, honey, because we can comb her out, honey, pop a little curling iron and some set curls in her, and bring this perm wedge right back to life. You guys love this unit so much. Like, I have more questions I want to say on this unit than I did the other two. This is a 1B perm wedge, and I absolutely fell in love with this unit. I wore her in the middle part, I wore her on the side, and she was just absolutely all the way fabulous. And look how long. Like, I'm stretching my arm all the way out and she is all the way long. And like I said, please don't get this mistaken, honey. We can comb her out and she can come right back into rotation. But because this one right here is, she's taking up shop right now, okay? So coming in at spot number 3, I'm going to give it up to perm wedge in the 1B. And then staying with my darker in hue, definitely coming in a close second to the perm wedge is this Adele unit. Beautifully long, very, very loose wave. And I really will say that I got used to what I like in 2016. It's crazy because certain units, I just feel like they weren't me per se. They needed a little bit too much tweaking on them. And, you know, at core, I still wanted the unit to make me feel like myself. So I think I'm just really a very easy, loose wave girl. Like, I've really gotten that down. And I love long wigs. I think they're very youthful. I think they're very fun. I think they are look all by themselves. I'm typically in all black, so having something that is edgy enough, but still youthful enough, but still personally me, I mean, I'm just obsessed with it. And I think Adele embodied all of that. And when I say youthful, I mean, I'm not trying to go into my mama's wig. You feel what I'm saying? Rounding up the top spots. And you guys knew this was going to happen, are my blonde units. And they are so close. Like, I have three, so I am cheating a little bit. I have three that I will say quintessentially are me at heart. Like, my hair doesn't grow out of my head as a blonde. However, I feel with my complexion, the blonde units are just me. Blonde units. They work with my complexion. I can't help that I'm super fair, looking like a light bulb sometimes, and this actually just allows me to warm my complexion up a little bit, okay? So first off, I'm going to talk about the unit that I bought twice. Like, this unit, again, it reminds me of Adele, and she is called Sensational's Easy 5, but it's this color, this blonde on top. I was also able to create a darker root with a little tweaking, and then it goes into this beautiful deep brown. Like, this is what I'm talking about. This looks like the hair that if my hair were to grow this long, this is what I would want to do with it. But because I know better, honey, we are not bleaching our hair this blonde anymore. But yeah, this unit I purchased twice. And again, I will leave her in the description box. I don't want to say that she was one of those units that came out in 2016, but I fell in love with the loose wave with this unit. Like, it really led me to some of the other ones that you've already seen in this review. And I just absolutely obsessed over this unit. So, yes, coming in third position. And how could I not? How could I not give it up for this Isis wig? Like, this unit was the one that put wig wearing on the map for me. Very, very hard to get access to this unit, and I think that a lot of other units are starting to take up shop, like the Dominican blowout wigs. We have this beautiful yakky texture. Again, I have the double coloring. Actually, this one is triple in coloring, so it's more of a honey blonde on top. It goes into like an auburn, and then it goes into this beautiful brown on the bottom. And again, I could shampoo her, honey, and put her right back into rotation. She was heat safe, and you know, anytime that she started to get a little kinkier than I wanted, that keep your mind on the video, guys. Keep your mind on the video. Anytime that I want to make her a little bit more wearable, I could just run a flat iron through her all the way up to 400 degrees. So I could not mention this beautiful Isis unit. But there's always a first position. There is always a first position, and that has to go to my It's a Wig beautiful unit in Swiss Lace Lancy. Oh my god, this unit, you guys, it was sent to me by It's a Wig, and I fell in love with the dark root. I fell in love with the parting space. I fell in love with this beautiful texture and that gorgeous DX. I want to say this is 216A. Oh my god, this unit right here, honey, I think I need to go ahead and place an order to go ahead and get her back in rotation, because as you can see, what I'm wearing right now is also a unit by It's a Wig. I will leave this unit in the description box. This is Montessa. This is also by the same company, and I am equally as obsessed with this one as I was with this one. So, as I said, 2017 is looking pretty bright, because 2016 wasn't quite so bad. So there you have my top units of 2016, and I'm not going to even say top five. I mean, it was just my top favorite units of 2016. And I'm hoping you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure you give it 2 thumbs up. Comment on some of your favorite units from 2016 that maybe I might need to try. Especially, honey, if they're in this blonde hue. Or you know what? Maybe I'll play with some pastels this year. Maybe I'll go back to auburn. Maybe we'll even try green or blue. You never know. You guys know that I love to connect with you, so make sure you connect with me. Follow me on all my social media. Here are the links right here. Make sure you subscribe to that channel and click that bell, honey. That way you will be notified every time I upload a video. Until next time, guys, thanks so much for watching. Hugs and kisses. We'll talk to you soon. Bye.